Netflix paid Anna Sorokin, the woman who pretended to be a German heiress named Anna Delvey, with a $60 million trust fund to scam banks and other financial institutions, $320,000 for the rights to adapt her life story into a TV series, Insider can exclusively reveal. Sorokin has used $199,000 of the money to pay restitution to the banks, plus another $24,000 to settle state fines, according to records reviewed by Insider. New York State froze Sorokin's funds in May 2019, a rare invocation of its Son of Sam law, which is designed to prevent criminals from profiting from their crimes. The law was passed in 1977 after publishers offered the Son of Sam serial killer David Berkowitz money for a memoir about his crimes. But with Sorokin paying off her victims, Albany County Judge Richard Platkin ordered the state's Office of Victim Services Thursday to unfreeze her bank account and allow her to use the funds she has left ahead of her expected release from prison next month. Ahead of Platkin's order, Sorokin formally agreed to pay the $70,000 in restitution she still owed to Citibank, court records reviewed by Insider showed. She had already paid the $100,000 she owed to City National Bank, the Wall Street Journal first reported. In addition to the roughly $223,000 she's paid in restitution and fines, Sorokin has also paid $75,000 in attorney fees and will owe more once legal proceedings in her case have concluded, leaving her little money left from the Netflix payout. Sorokin first came into the national spotlight in spring 2018 after a New York Magazine story by Jessica Pressler about her exploits using her fake identity to run in wealthy Manhattan circles and jump between Soho hotels to maintain a high-flying lifestyle. She had planned to obtain funds from banks to develop the Anna Delvey Foundation, a mixed arts and restaurant space that, if successful, would enable her to pay them all back. Sorokin was ultimately arrested in 2017 on grand-larceny charges and sat trial in 2019. She was found guilty of 8 counts and acquitted on 2, including the most severe one, attempted grand-larceny of over $1 million from City National Bank. Judge Diane Kiesel, who oversaw the criminal case, sentenced her to 4 to 12 years in prison, including the 2 years she had already spent in Rikers Island jail ahead of the trial. Sorokin was granted early release for February 2021, a New York State Department of Corrections and Community Supervision spokesperson told Insider. Sorokin filed for direct appeal after the losses in her criminal case, which experts said could have allowed her to hold on to her Netflix payment for longer. If her appeal was successful, she might not have to pay anything at all, according to Dmitriy Shakhnevich, a professor at the John Jay College of Criminal Justice and expert in the Son of Sam law.